you like to play on this map, being a top-notch player yourself, Mano?
Yeah, I think I will just play like Frigate Expand, like my, like MC did on Metal Opus. I think this is just the face, the safest build to play like maps on Metal Opus or Zelnaga Caverns.
What do you think about a Zerg player just trying to get a lot of Zerglings early on before building drones in order to pressure a Protoss player on this map? Because as you already stated, the expansion is really hard to defend, as there's a lot of space where you can attack from, and you can always try to sneak into the main base of your opponent if mm-hmm. he doesn't pay attention. So what do you think about that? Should Morrow maybe try that, or will he stick to his economic build once again?
I think Morrow will stick to his economic build, but I like the Zergs. That they are doing additional zerging just to force Protoss to stay safe on his Nexus while they are expanding, and they have to force Protoss to maybe sometimes even cancel the Nexus and lose some minerals, and then even run by to the main of the Protoss player when you have only some additional zergings, and you don't lose that much economy actually.
By the way, we have the 7-8 core being built, and obviously we have more MC once again trying to wall in as you would like to versus a Zerg player. And Bromo pulling off the drone from his extractor, trying to get additional minerals. We have the Queen being built right now for him, as well as the speed for his Zerglings. And of course, he will try to get an expansion as soon as he hits, well, the 21, 22 supply mark. Here we go on 20 supply. Morrow is actually trying to get to his expansion in order to sneak in actually. No, he's scouting. He's scouting with his probe, and the Overlord is already in place as well, having a look what's happening at the choke point. And yeah, here we go with the Zerglings being ready to defend against any natural Brock. But MC isn't even trying to do that. Morrow right now placing down his hatchery, and MC already researching his Warpgate upgrade. And as you can see, we have two gas for him already. He's still on one gateway, but up here we have the pylon, so we can expect to see additional gateways really, really soon.
Yep. I think, MC will go definitely for the Frigate Expand, as this is the safest build for this map. And Morrow still playing the same, the fourth game in the row, playing only drones. He wants to take the economic advantage, but I'm not sure if this is the right decision to do the same thing in all of the games. As you see, he surprised MC in game number 3 when MC did the fast expansion with Forge, and then Morrow perfectly did the aggression with the Banelings and with the Speedlings, with the Overlords, just doing aggressive style, which MC couldn't even fight with.
What would you recommend MC to do? I mean, he played a lot of straight-up games lately, and we've seen him play basically the same style with small variations against Morrow so far. He knows that the style of the Zerg player by now. On this map, where scouting the main base of your opponent is really, really hard, especially as a Zerg player, would you actually like him, well, to cheese a little bit, maybe go for a Nexus cancel? Because Morrow really seems to be vulnerable against exactly this kind of strategy.
Yeah, I think if MC would cancel his Nexus and go for the 5-gate rush, Morrow wouldn't be even prepared for that. But as we see, there's a little bit of dead space on the back of main of MC. There's a little bit of Overlord, and he can see if MC will going to cancel his Nexus or not, but it doesn't look like MC doesn't is not adding additional gateways, so we might see just the straight game by MC. But if he will do that, it will be very good, I think.
We have a Roach Run. We have two Spine Crawlers for Morrow, and placing a Roach Run as well, so actually he is kind of safe. I have to say, in the meantime, there are Zerglings, sneaking in, nice, scouting the main base of the opponent is always a good thing, and Morrow being able to sneak two Zerglings into the main base of MC is aware of everything that's happening right now, so really nice for him to have some additional scouting information, and he knows that there's no 5-gate, so he can actually concentrate on his economy right now.
That was very, very nice scouting by Morrow, and now MC's adding a target right now, so he will be safe versus any Roach aggression right now, and but it doesn't look like Morrow is going to do any aggression, as he's making only drones right now and Overlords, so I think he will do the third expansion very, very soon, and MC is moving out just to scare Morrow or even do a little bit of aggression right now, since Morrow has only two Spine Crawlers and not even a single Zergling to defend.
We have 8 roaches queued up, though, and a forge being placed as well. Here, the spine crawler Smoro already really, really nice at spreading his creep. And the roaches will be out in a second. He's pulling off all his drones and losing a little bit of mining time. Not too much, though. And here are the spine crawlers being attacked. There's not enough energy on the queen for a transfuse. But here are those roaches. And immediately, we see force fields. The second spine crawler being killed. And now, Moro is moving in with the roaches, producing an additional 3. The force fields of MC just beautiful, taking out the queen as well, and that was quite a nice attack.
Yeah,
by
that
MC.
Was a very nice army change by MC. He killed like two queens and a few roaches, and he lost like only two zealots and maybe no, not even lost a single sentry. So that was a very nice change by MC, and now he's making a phoenix as he has already one void ray done to take a little bit of aggression for tomorrow, and Morrow doesn't have even a second queen on his natural, so he won't be able to defend that very, very quickly.
Yeah, and I think that was exactly what MC was going for, taking out the queen and realizing that his opponent didn't have that many units. So he can kill that queen straight away, just lifting it up with the graviton beam. That is exactly what he's doing right now. So this queen will be history in a few seconds. Very, very well played by MC so far. He will be able to take the queen out. In the meantime, we see the first spore crawler being built, and that void ray is able to deal a lot of damage to the Zerg player. And actually, Morrow has a lot of trouble on his hands right now.
And there are a few roaches, maybe several roaches, with the burrow and with the tunneling almost already done so. And MC has only one cannon in the mineral line, and I'm not sure if Morrow is going to do a lot of damage, because MC has the detection already.
And this void ray was saved by MC. MC dealing a huge amount of damage. Look at that. There's detection by now. And Morrow, oh my god, I think he is in a lot of trouble. He's researching speed. He's getting more roaches, trying to get out of the range of the cannon in order to be not detected. 10 kills on that void ray over here. We have the hydrolysis ready and a bunch of roaches as well. And now Morrow is just retreating with his army. An observer being built, so MC won't be surprised by borrowed roaches again. We have the +1 attack upgrade. And MC just playing so stable right now. He did a lot of damage with his early push to the economy of his opponent. Yeah, first of all, he killed the queen. Then he went in with the Phoenix and the Void Ray. Was able to pick off the queen with a graviton beam. And immediately went for the drones after he killed the queen. So that was actually very, very well done by MC. Morrow lost a lot already. 26 units lost, resources 2,000. And the Phoenix are still flying over the map and just trying to attack the Zerg player, picking off overlords and denying scouting possibilities for the Zerg player. So right now, Morrow in a lot of trouble.
Yes, indeed. And now MC is killing 5 free Hydras from Morrow, and now he tries to kill the third expansion by Morrow, and MC is just predicting every single move by Morrow, and he's doing it very perfectly, and he's taking the gold expansion right now, as he has no immortals yet. And now Morrow coming with a lot of roaches and burrow and tunneling. Will he be able to move into the main base of MC?
And just Morrow, basically, what is MC doing? He doesn't have a Colossus, he can't get through those force fields. Actually, if Morrow is able to get through, but look at that, he's not able to unborrow, and therefore he's losing quite a large amount of units. And now Morrow just trying to kill as many harvesters as possible. The Phoenixes are already there, using the Graviton Beam as a defense. Morrow trying to pick off the economy of his opponent. He's on 110 supply against 123 right now, and all the time we have that one observer for the Protoss player. MC doing quite a lot of damage to Morrow's attack army, but as you can see, Morrow just trying to annoy his opponent as much as possible. 38 army supply for Morrow right now against 63 harvesters against 52.
Oh my god, that was brilliant play, brilliant defense by MC, and his gold expansion.
I like the idea.
Yeah, and Morrow third is not even in halfway, and MC gold is already done, so I think MC is in a very, very, very good position right now. Morrow has only a lot of Hydras, but only 4 roaches right now. He has to make any army, because MC is about to attack him.
And here we see once again Queens being picked off, Graviton being used as well. 136 supply against 120. Moro trying to get additional roaches, researching plus one attack upgrade, and MC just moving and killing all those street tumors left and right, unknown, killing everything in his path and trying just to force the creep back towards the main base of his opponent in order to be a little bit safer. And well, Moro with a huge amount of trouble right now. I really don't know what he's supposed to do. But again, this play by Moro, we have seen that quite often, and it didn't work so far against MC. It doesn't work on the fourth map, apparently. The force fields are too good by MC, and he's just retreating so well. As soon as he sees the Burrow Roaches, he's just reacting perfectly, trying to take out the third base, and once again, the force fields. It's amazing. I think his sentries have an unlimited amount of energy. They have force fields like crazy. I mean, look at that.
But still, oh no, there's not enough roaches for Moro to defeat this army. I think MC is going to take this game, and that's GG.
And MC is taking the semi-final and is winning against Moro 3-1, advancing to the final, and shake hands by the two players. And that's it, so embraced by MC. MC with an amazing performance. Moro was not up to the task, and we have MC in the final.